and these are my YouTube videos are there, English, Hindi, Telugu and Tamil. I am a Tamilian but Puriyaga vandu Tirunelveli, ana perandha valandha north la valandha. I have three counseling right now for past 5 years. I am in Chennai. One is in OMR, one is in Virgambakkam, another is in Tambaram. And ipo Skype counseling, ongoing counseling last 1 week apachi over wash pannit irukken. This I want to share with you the Facebook post. Okay, this was very very exciting to me. I thought let me share with you. Adha or madam vandu, this is one of my own colleagues. She has put that t-shirt and enna solranga na, I am okay, na nalla da iruken, unga unga paiyanudeya paarva dhaan thavaru, na nalla da iruken, unga paiyanudeya paarva dhaan avaru appadina, adukku vandu or nariya like poite irukku, 600 plus like, ipo 700 vandirukku nenikken. I will come to that afterwards. Okay, so thank you for coming. Ipo enna na, I want to tell you one small example. Na vand apartment la irukkumbodhu kaalaiyila thanni varum.
Speak in English.
I can hear you.
Yeah, please speak in English. We don't know Tamil.
Am I audible to you?
Sir, so speak in English language, sir. We don't understand Tamil.
Okay, but
you want me to tell in Tamil or in English?
No, sir.
English, English.
In English, okay? Right. So let me tell you an example in my own experience. We used to stay in apartment. There water is definitely early in the morning around 5 o'clock. Water is to flow plenty, and I have to tell my wife. My wife to tell my mother to tell my father, then uncle. By the time 1 hour is over, water will be still running. And by the time tap is closed, almost the liters of water is gone. So what happened after some time? What happened? There was a scarcity of water. Then the apartment people told it will come after 8:30, 9 o'clock. What time it will come, I do not know. You have to come with your utensil. Every person will have only one bucket. So we are all standing in the queue in the night, and we had to change the shift system. I was for 1 hour shift, then my mother, then my sister, then my sister-in-law. At that time, you knew the value of water. So whatever it is, plenty or free, we don't know the value. But just because it is coming free to you, please don't think that is valueless. That is my only request. The same course, when I go to corporate, minimum this is the amount I charge. This is the value you are getting. Provided you value yourself, you will be able to see value in that. Otherwise, it is simply water for you. Okay. The flow will be like this. First, I will have an introduction flow, then the 5 protocols, then a few of my case studies from my experience. Then we will open for Q&A. Is it okay, madam? Rama, madam? Hello?
Yes, sir.
It's okay.
Hello?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir. Okay? Okay, sir. Okay, fine.
Okay, Rama, madam.
Yes, okay, right. Sir. Fine.
Hello, once again, go for the same process. Okay. Actually, these are a few. I would say a few protocols which we follow, because I belong to a different schools of psychology, mostly absorbed from the West. One is diagnostic counseling and not advisory counseling. I don't take client the moment they call me up or the moment they come for consultancy. I talk to them over phone, free of cost. I diagnose them whether they are my case or not, whether they will work for me or not, and I don't charge for that. The initial consultancy we don't charge, because I want to educate my clients. So what will be the benefit, how they to go about it. So that is how I differ. Our school of thinking differs from others. NRIs, of course, I charge. For her, I don't charge. If a husband is talking for them, I will tell, I have to talk to your wife. I talk to both the parties free of cost, and afterward I ask them, what do you expect from me? They have to give an email. Once the email comes, then only I talk about my fees. Until then, free of cost. So for every session, second protocol you follow, every homework for every session. No homework, no counseling. This is the eligibility criteria. And they have to come with a V meeting diary. Adnan wife has to come with a V meeting diary. My team will ask at the reception itself, meeting konadingla, meeting diary konadingla. Ama. Then only, otherwise, please go get the diary. Third is, I use psychometric tools, particularly Enneagram, very powerful tool in diagnosing very precisely. And the fourth one is, we use a lot of video assignments, book assignments, because now education has stopped. So, until unless you re-educate yourself, you update yourself, you will not be in a position to work. Then afterward, depending upon the case, we also select certain role models. They have to go and talk to some senior couples. Two from our side, two from their side. They have to make a script. Like doing like a project work. What we do is more than counseling, we are focusing on mentoring. It is like a mother taking care of a child. So these are the basic protocols. You can see that being reflected in all of us. Let me tell you the small story of a 9-year-old boy. And he hails from Tamil Nadu. He was in North, or amma or appa, appa and then getting now, the father used to had his own way of helping his own brothers and sister at the cost of his wife. So lot of misunderstanding between this lady and her husband. And the lady at the 9-year-old boy, one day she told, come, we'll go to God. Your father is torturing us a lot. We'll go to God. The boy, 9-year-old boy, likes his mother. He told, okay, we'll go to God. He thought as if it's going to a park. So every night the story was there, but never she called for going to God. But one day around 7:30, she told, come, your father is starting, we'll go to God. This boy also went. She went to Hanumanji temple. There a small well was there. She pushed the boy inside. And the boy was telling, what is that you are asking me to come to God and you are pushing me in the water? No, no, there is a shortcut from here. And we'll go from here. Then she holds the nostril of the boy and her own nostril. And he was pressing and the boy started clapping and splashing hands, crying, shouting. And the whole village, the whole temple came. And the temple pujari took all of them and he started giving a counseling. The boy was asked. The boy was asked one question. Hello.
సార్ వచ్చావా హైదరాబాద్కి
హలో
సార్
కంటిన్యూ
సార్
కంటిన్యూ
ఎస్ ప్లీజ్ సార్
ద బాయ్ వాజ్ ఆస్క్డ్ విల్ దిస్ బ్యాడ్ నేమ్ ఇన్క్రీజ్ ఆర్ డిక్రీజ్ ఇఫ్ యూ కమిట్ సూసైడ్ ద బాయ్ టోల్డ్ ఇట్ విల్ ఇన్క్రీజ్ డూ యూ వాంట్ దట్ ద బాయ్ టోల్డ్ నో ఐ డోంట్ వాంట్ బ్యాడ్ నేమ్ ఫర్ మై మదర్ దెన్ యూ డోంట్ కమిట్ సూసైడ్ And you have to educate your mother and father. And the boy told, okay, I will educate. So that is small boy is the person at that time. He did not think that he will become an engineer, he will become a PhD, he will become a doctor. The same boy is nothing but now in front of you, he is giving you the webinar. My mother has suffered so much. She has cried so much. That pain is still there in me. So I am helping a prospective mother and a prospective father. And a missionary is in to help around 1 million couples. So because of this only I am there, but as such I am retired from a company and I am here well versed, earning a lot, but only because of this pain. I always tell, I have given, my mother has cried so much for everybody on the earth. I don't want my mother to cry, anybody else. So, any girl, any mother is a prospective mother and father for me. So, I am helping them out. That is my mission to 1 million young couples, the knowledge of whatever I had. And this 1 million I cannot achieve on my own. I want support from all of you. That passion only makes me to do something else. At 64, I don't call I'm 64, I'm 34. I'm the same story I've been telling for the last 30 years. So I'm young, I'm passionate. Yes, I received around 20% of my mission. I had a bigger plan. I want you to help me out. So I'll go to the next scene. I hope you're all able to hear me. Sometimes the signals are becoming a problem for me. So kindly you can stop me in case I'm not audible to you. So yeah, this was the story. Why I am in this, I would say this is a God given syllabus. God made syllabus for me. Okay. So it is not the question of hungry doctor. Even client should also be hungry. See, the modern youth they are facing is they are away from parents. They are away from the culture. They are away from their friends. They are away from the relatives. So born in Noida, working in Chennai. Born in Chennai, working in Noida. Hyderabad, Delhi, Assam. A lot of my clients, I have a clinic in OMR. A lot of my clients are North Indian clients. They talk to me in Hindi. Everybody has having some pain in their life which they want to share. To whom to share, what to share, when to share, how to share. Because what they are looking is that the timely advice, the timely suggestion. So they are feeling there is a missing of their mother and father. There is a missing link of they want a mother, they want a father for themselves. That is what I am doing. I am a mother, I am a father to them. So let me tell you what actually happened in the young couple case. They were living in groups. This was a BPO company and they had their own method of working and living together and all those things. And enjoying together, all the young group. But I will be sharing certain stark realities which you might not have come across in your life. Or maybe a cinema story for you. But for me, it's a real story for me. Then what has happened? One boy and one girl were a part of there. They got married. They had a children. And slowly the lady wanted to return back to the normal life. Enough is enough, we'll go. But the gent told, no, I will not. I want that. I want once again, we should go and live with a group. So the lady is ready to change. But the gent is not ready to change. Then they came to me and afterward went into process one by one by one. Then please understand, if a mother was there, if a brother was there, if a sister was there, what happened? Every day fight, mother will fight, brother will fight, sister will fight. That many corrections will happen every day. They have not gone to a worst point, not gone to a breakthrough point. So that is where they feel they are losing their contact with their mother and father. They want still a mother and father. See, we all want our mother. Why we have friends? They are our mothers. Any problem, we go to our mother, friend circle, useful or useless, but still we want some person who can give us some suggestion. Okay? Sir, how many of you agree with me? Any PPT is not visible? Okay, I'll just check it out. I wanted your aha moment. Did you listen to me? Are you still listening to me? What is your response to my story? Yes, Munish, thank you. Prakash. Gupta, Merlin, Kanishka, thank you. It's a real story. Tamil, okay. I'll go ahead. Thank you, Uma. Thank you, Pallavi. Thank you, Sudha. Okay, I agree with you. Thank you, Vishnupriya. Shah Muhammad, I'll go back to the next story because I have, this is one story which I already shared with you. So they had a hunger. This couple had a hunger. The lady had hunger to come out of that. That is the reason she only bought the husband n number of times. But most of the time, what actually happening is one of the root causes is wrong assumption. You know what is wrong assumption? Assumption is what I think is the truth. See, let us say you are a good in commerce. You're a commerce student. But are you good in accounting? Are you good in auditing? Can you be a good chartered accountant? Can you be a good cost accountant? No. It is a different skill, isn't it? Even though you are a commerce student, the skills are different. Isn't it? Suppose you are a good banker, you have been put in an audit department, you have to learn, relearn once again. You have to forget certain things and relearn because the skill is different. Your mother may be good in making coffee, excellent, but Suppose she has to make an Italian coffee. What she has to do? She has to unlearn and relearn. But what we see is, I know how to make coffee, therefore I can make coffee for the whole world. So that is the assumption. To understand that is a mistake, it takes 10 years for them. I'm good in my profession. I can manage my boss. I can manage my subordinates. I can earn my salary. Therefore, I can earn anything. I can earn my family also. With that assumption, or my mother is there enough to take care of my wife. After 5 years, 6 years, when they go to the pain at that time, they go for help. One of the main reason is wrong assumption. Because I'm a good professional, therefore I can manage my profession, therefore I can manage every department of life. No. Your company is run on the systems, and your relationship is run on emotions. So until unless you know the difference, and unless you appreciate the difference, you will not be able to focus on that. It takes some time for you to understand, yes, that is different. So how many of you agree with me? Company is run on systems and relationship is run on emotions. And, Rajnikant, South Indian, he used to say, but for running the company, this is the requirement. For running a family, this is the requirement. So this and this skills are not same. But we assume it is right. Thank you, Ramya, Asha, Madhavan, sir, thank you. Emotions are very important, right? Many of my clients come to me, sir, I am an MBA. You tell me, how can I fix my husband? Because that is the language, terminology they have learned. Hey, thank you very much. I'll go for the next session. So, yeah, a mother came to me and she had a problem with the child, and the child was, he has broke the head of somebody else in the school, and the school has rusticated him because he has been given enough warning, and the mother is a single mother. She doesn't know what to do. She's working a BPO, and this boy broke the head, and the whole police department has come. The other person is very powerful. So the school teacher has to run. She came to my clinic with the boy. She cannot show the case to anybody else because both the parties are equal to the principal. So principal told, because that school, I go as a counselor to them. Then the mother was crying, sir, what shall I do? Now my boy is being rusticated. I told, madam, this is something, warning has been given, I cannot do anything. And I told him, why don't you put the boy in a something which you can, which he can like, some hobby which he likes. He told, sir, I am ready to put anywhere, but I am only worried tomorrow I will go to office. This fellow will once again fight with somebody, he will be on the road. I don't know what to do. I told him, I got a psychometric test and I will be able to help you out. She told, money is not a problem, sir, but kindly help me out. I did a psychometric, then after 2 days, I went through that. NLP techniques, we put all those things. Then what I found out is this boy is having a muscular skill. There is two types of it. A gross muscular skill and kind of fine muscular skills. Gross muscular skills are living heavy weight, jumping, then lifting the weight. Okay, this is called gross muscular skills, a sportsman skill. And fine muscular skills, what our young mothers and our sisters, they do, know, for knitting it, or for cutting onions, or cutting garlic, okay, for removing garlic. That's got fine muscular skill. This boy had a lot of gross muscular skill. And I went through the chart. I was reading them that you can go to this area, you can go for kabaddi, you can go for basketball, you can go for this. One by one, these are the areas suggested for you. I told dancing. The moment I uttered the word dancing, this fellow started jumping. Mama, I told you I like dancing, I want to go there. The boy told, sir, this fellow is a very crazy guy about dancing, a useless guy. Always keeps on something, useless dancing. I told, what is useless to you, it is now useful to me. So you have no other option, put him in dancing school. Mother reluctantly agreed. At around 5:30 evening, mother went to office. This boy, from my clinic, straight he went to 4 dancing schools. Took the application form, made the cost-benefit analysis. Next day, he took money from mother and he joined. See, the boy who is breaking the head here is, see how he is working for the dancer. Because this particular knowledge was missing. Okay, what is happening? We are spoiling the future of the child because we are ignorant. To tell you frankly, this boy started slowly. What happened? He asking, Mama, my friends are coming. Why don't you make upma? He told, I cannot give upma and all those things. This fellow started making upma and chutney for the mother. And by the time the boys are coming, he skipped everything. Now he's cooking also. He's dancing also. Dancing in YouTube. See, the fighter has become a dancer now. The fighter has become a dancer now. See, it is something like a dam. Suppose it is like a flood. What happens to the flood if we don't control it? It will wash over the whole village, it will the whole country. But if you put it on a dam and you curve a circuit, you can convert into a field. Then you can take it to a field. Agreed? That is what it is. Lack of professional help. Fighter to dancer. Who was fighting, breaking the head, breaking the skull, blood, injury, every day some case, now had to become a dancer. This is only because what actually is happening is they do not know or they are reluctant to take professional help. Okay. So your response to this, sir, because I just want to know whether other side what is happening, because I have a limitations in this. Rajeshwari, thank you. Am I audible, first of all? Hi, yeah. Thank you, Payal ji, Suresh, Pallavi, Prasanna, at least I can remember the Madhavi, Ramya, Rajeshwari. Thank you. What is your response about this, Madhavi? How do you feel about this case? I don't know if they are mother or not. Any mothers are there? You can just put one word. Yeah, this is a talent. This is a talent, but school psychologists are not enough. We do not have proper psychologists in the schools. So either what happened, the talent, otherwise what will happen, this fellow will go break and he will be in the police station. We are spoiling the future of one child because of neither mother is taking professional help. Now we are training professionals in that area. His energy is channelized. Prakash ji, you are right. His energy is channelized. Okay, but only thing is because mother has taken the story. Right, thank you, I go ahead. I am used to Zoom. That is the reason I.
Sir, let the screen be there, sir. You needn't shut it down, sir. The present now screen, let it be there permanently.
Is the screen?
Yes, sir. Because if you go and come back, there's a time is getting wasted in
between. But I want to see myself, no? Because I have to see the chat also.
No, you can see the chat. You can't see yourself. Your presentation will be there if you come.
Sir. Okay. Then
thank,
okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. So, this is the story of fighter dancer. Let me go to the second, the third one which I am seeing is most of my clients, 50% of the clients, the career misfit. 3 days ago, a client called me, maybe around 35 or 37 years, and he's an engineer. And he says, sir, I'm not having the same energy to work, same interest to work. I do not know why. My hunger is getting spoiled. My recognition is not there for me. The same office which he recognized me, the same boss who helped me out, now he is taking back. I also feel I'm not able to participate actively, energetically. I do not know why. So most of the cases when I analyze, 50% of this is because they are career misfit. When I went into that guy is a creative guy. Okay. He has got an inborn love for music, dance. He comes from a very different field. He comes from a very Bharatanatyam family. He wanted to pursue Bharatanatyam career. He wanted to pursue music. But certain reason, somebody forced them or he went for certain reason, he went into engineering. And now, after 3 years or 4 years, what happened? He has become misfit. He's not able to grow. So, 90% of the cases I have seen is the people are misfit is because their inborn love is different and they have chosen a wrong career, either because they do not know how to select a career or nobody guided them. And most of the people they say, no, that I tried that, oh, nothing is there, okay, mechanical engineering is okay, that seat is okay, this college is okay. They have, as if they have chosen a chocolate, not even a brand chocolate, whatever is available to them. That is where most of the careers are misfit. Okay. They are like a square in a round hole. And this is the one of the reasons they are unhappy. This unhappiness reflects on the boss in the office life, in the wife life, in the family life. Because they are unhappy with themselves. They find mistakes with their couples, with their children. Now, first of all, we'll see it is something when they themselves are unhappy, where they will find happiness. This is another thing which I have found out among mostly the cases who come to me is like this. Oh, sorry, 1 second. That's it. 1 second, let me check up myself. Yeah. Yeah, a response to this, the second case, that career misfits. How many of you agree with me? You can differ with me. You have a right. Because once you start messaging something, then I think you are listening to me. How did you find a hidden talent? That we go through a psychometric tools, I told you, no? Psychometric tool is there. Prasanna, thank you. Yeah. Devi Priya, right? Okay. Okay, Paul Raj, thank you. Because these only because we were not knowledgeable at that time or we did not have proper guidance. Okay, even me also know why I went to engineering. I was an average engineer. The moment I moved on to training department, I was a star of the company. I was the average or below average guy when I was in production department. But accidentally, I went into training department. Okay, and I was become the star of the company because I'm born for learning, sharing. I did not know at that time. Nobody was there to guide me. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Prasanna, you are right. It will affect the career. But there are options. I am not telling now, now they have to go back once again to identify the passion. But there are options. Now we cannot ask them after 30 years, 40 years to choose another career. But we can still help them out. Okay. I'll go to the next one. Then I'll go to the fourth one, fourth point I wanted to share, is wrong parenting. See, first of all, you have to understand, it is like a baby who says, I want chocolate. How much chocolate do you want? Maybe a box full. No, not a box full. I want a room full. I don't want room full. I want apartment full of chocolates. I can eat. That is the status of the mind of the baby at that age. Only mother will know what will happen to the baby if so much chocolate happens. Isn't it? So similarly, my couples do not know. They think they are stressful only because it has happened in the office or it happened with the partner. Okay? They are carrying a stress pattern which is exported, which is imported from their father and grandfather. That is enough. I am coming up with a book called Married Couple Version 2. There I am writing all those things. So, five generational stress. See. The case of a couple, both were in love for 3 years. Both were in love for 3 years and, sorry, is jumping up. Anna. Both were in love for 3 years and they purchased the apartment after marriage and within 1 week, what happened? The girls are noticing a strange behavior. So whenever somebody knocks on the door, the boy is scared. He runs away. Then after 2 days, he told, no, I don't want any people coming here. So he told, we'll shift the apartment. She told, why are you worried about it? Any apartment will be like this and I will handle it. The lady was handling it. So sometimes the gas cylinder fellow will come, some the electricity bill will come, some the milk fellow will come, he's going to run away. Then after 1 week, she found out that this boy was, in the night, whole night he was crying. She told, what happened? Why are you crying? She is now discovering, even though they were in 2 year love, she did not discover this side of the story. She asked them, what happened? Why are you crying? Oh, no, 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 not crying. I'm very much scared. Same thing. People are coming and disturbing us. Yesterday, apartment people came. Association people were talking to you for two hours, three hours. I don't want that to happen. She told, this is a part of life. Whether you go to this apartment, that apartment will always be there. Then the boy told, no, no, it will not happen. I will take some apartment where nobody will disturb us. He told, this can never happen. No, no, Alto, I know a friend of that. I will do that. So he told the girl to go to a mother's place. This boy went to mother's place. He thought he can solve the problem in 1 year, 1 week. Now 3 months are over. Both are separate. Then the process of patching up happened. Then the daughter-in-law told the mother-in-law, father-in-law, sir, this is a problem with your son. So father-in-law told, why you are worried for us? Why you are making a small issue for all these small things? This thing my wife is also doing. My wife also cries. I adjust and she becomes normal. So please understand, this blueprint pattern is not something which has happened here. It has happened from the father and grandfather. Are you getting my point? Okay. This has to be corrected there, because the grandfather has not corrected, it has come to mother. Mother has not corrected, it has come to son. We only try to fight at the front end, not at the back end. We try to fight at the front end. Then she told, uncle, what you are telling is right. But I have got aims and ambitions. I want to have my own, aims and ambitions, and I cannot become a mother to your son. Okay. I am ready to leave the boy and I am ready to go ahead. Okay. So this was a shock to him. Okay. And a big gap. They refused to go together. So have you understood that behavior, what you're carrying, is not from your behavior. Behavior you're carrying is from your parents and grandparents. This is one of the things which I want the psychologist to understand and work on it. Not work on advice. Immediately plunge into advice, what will happen? You do not know the root cause. Once you do not know the root cause, you can never help him, because the psychologist's image is going down because we are doing advisory counseling. We don't do our homework. Sorry, there are exceptional psychologists are there. Okay. So this particular case is what? This is a case, very clear case of an imported behavior of the generations. And all the stress are all like this only. Okay. Right. Sir, your response, sir. Your audience, with your permission, I'll have some tea. Meanwhile, you can... Yeah, yeah, transgender issue. Valli Valikala, counselor. Good, good. Counselor, very good analysis. Bharti. Valli, right. Thank you.
There is a question, sir. Someone is, Sivareka has asked, what was the problem for the boy? Can you repeat, sir?
Boy had a phobia of meeting people. He cannot people on the gates. And that he has been hiding with a girl. And now, after marriage only, it has come to surface. And this behavior is the behavior which is accepted behavior in their family. Okay, ma?
Yes, sir.
Social anxiety. Yeah,
proceed.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Proceed, sir.
Right. I'll go to the next one. Few more slides. Yeah. The last one. Last one is a very, very important slide, not because it's exciting. It has changed my paradigm. And this is one of the reasons why I went permanently into counseling. I told you I was working for Bell, Bharat Heavy Electrical Limited, Tirchi. Then I was in Delhi, then Noida, then in Hyderabad. So we used to recruit, because it's 1 lakh employees, every month there will be retirement. Thousands of people will be going at the top level. And minimum 2,000 entries will be there, engineers and MBAs and all. We used to recruit from... And 1 year training, big hostel. I am the mother and father for them. They away from mother, away from father, 1 year training. And I have seen the worst and worst there. Living in group, creating problem, caught in the police station, helping them out, bringing them out. And some of them got remarried. So one of the lady students was hinting me, both got married. She told, sir, your student is not doing properly. You advise him, you counsel him, you are a great person. I told, I cannot advise him, I cannot counsel him, until unless you give me a case. or you give an evidence. She told, okay, sir, I'll come with evidence. She had a nursing maybe. One day she bought husband. No, you come to sir, we'll go. Both of them came to my cabin. And she told, sir, your student is having a lot of extramarital affairs. Every time you are sending to site, he's having one story. He comes and shares with that. With me, and I'm very much scared this boy is doing like this. Then I was only looking at him. Say, what is this boy? Your wife is complaining. So he told, after listening to that, he told, sir, why is big complaint, sir? Why she is making a lot of issue about the small issue? If she wants, let her also enjoy. Let she also enjoy, sir. I will supply the partner. Why she is complaining about me? This was something which I didn't expect from this guy. And immediately, next second, was a big pandemonium. This mother took the baby, threw me on my table, and pulled that fellow's collar, threw him out. He had an injury, and she ran away, broke the glass, and ran away. Then I was a little scared. 2 days over, 3 days over, and I was trying to catch this boy. Boy was not there. One day, I caught him. He was playing volleyball. After 6th, 7th day, I was trying to get him. He was avoiding my phone. And I told him, what happened? Where are you? Sir, I'm very much here, sir. You're not lifting my phone. No, sir, I was busy, sir. Okay, what happened to your wife? Where is she? I don't know, sir. After 7 days, he's telling, I don't know. What do you mean by I don't know? Sir, I'm from that day, she went up. Every time she does like that, sir, she goes somewhere and she comes back. I told her, I don't know all those things. You do one thing. You immediately find out where she is and report to me. Within 24 hours, if you are not reporting, I'm going to mark you absent. I will transfer you from Trichy to Delhi. You don't know, no, sir, I will find out. He went there, he did all his homework. And what actually happened is, this lady took the baby, purchased some rat poison. She went to her sister's house. And some big function is there, sister was not there. She kept the baby there with the group, and she was on the top floor, there is a water tank. On water tank, she is crying. 6-7 days, sister did not come. And NLP, I think Rama Madam knows about it. In NLP, we classify the personality and the visual, auditory, and category. Three categories. This guy is a visual guy, creative guy. That lady is a sensitive guy. I told this boy, see, you are a creative guy. Okay, for you, everything is creativity. You don't mean what you mean. But that lady is a sensitive lady. For you, a word is for enjoyment. For that word is an injured word for her. So if something happens, I am not responsible. So, conflict between creative personality and wife is a sensitive personality. Okay? That is something I would say, a poet. Okay? A poet and a mother. Poet is in his world. Okay? A sensitive girl is in her world. What will happen? So, he went and he fell at the feet of his wife and told, doctor told me, I am that guy, you are right, I know all those things. My intention was not that. My intention was only to tell you if you want, but if you don't want, okay, I will change. And I don't want you to commit suicide. She told, this is what I have attempted. And they came back. Next day, she called me and thanked me. She told, thank you very much, sir. If that fellow would have come at least 2 hours late, he would have found my dead body. So that made me think, okay, NLP is such a powerful psychotherapy tool that I'm able to classify. Looking at the eyeball movement, there is an eyeball movement therapy. Look at the eyeball movement, you can classify the personalities. So this powerful science should take shape in the country. This should be taught to every youth. There are many more things. All NLP students, I don't know how many of you are NLP are there, whether they've been taught to you properly or not, because many people are taking wrong shapes. In fact, in India, I am the only person. In 2002, I wrote one book in Tamil, Vetri Kadavu. One in Telugu. At that time, I was in Hyderabad. My first NLP book of India, my experience, it was written in Telugu and it was released by Akineni Nageshwarrao. Akineni Nageshwarrao is the Nagarjuna's father. He read me, used to write my articles, used my other articles. So I would say I'm the first person to start that India. And so NLP is a powerful tool. And from that day, I thought, yes, I can counsel them. That is how I went into counseling. Shah, I wanted your aha moment, any learning, any sharing, please type it. Jaita, yeah, Jaita Shah, NLP. You might have heard about VAK, Jaita ji? Visual Auditory Kinesthetic. Yeah, that guy is a visual guy, girl is a kinesthetic guy. You're right. Thank you, Madhavi. Oh, it's there are different schools of psychology. If you depend on one school of psychology, most of the psychologists are not able to do because we don't focus on application psychology. Most of the syllabus our Suresh sir also knows. Yeah, you can come to me. I'll tell you all those things. Suresh sir will tell me. You can contact me, all those things. And my number is already there. Okay, so this helped me to classify this client immediately. That is where I had that. Okay, I'll go to the. This is a case where I told you, no? Sorry. Okay, so I had a verification. I'll close this in another 15 minutes. Suresh sir, okay, sir? 15 minutes close, pannalama? Rama madam.
Yeah, fine, sir. Fine.
Okay, okay, sir. So I'll go to this. So who is the root cause? Who is the root cause for all this? You know, so far I have been sampling about the front end symptoms. So when a tree is coming, there is a seed, isn't it? Without a seed, a tree will not come. So many experts are there here. Would you please tell me who is the root cause for all this problem? Yeah, I want response from the audience, a very matured audience, of NLP audience. Parenting, Radha. Yeah, very good. Right, anything else? Yeah, lack of true understanding and love. Srivika, Prasanna, Madhavi, Ramya, the new society, Asha, very good perception. Okay, all right, I'll go into the what has actually happened is mother is the root cause. Mother is the root cause. Why my mother attempted suicide? You tell me. She had low self-esteem. Are you getting my point? My mother has attempted suicide. She took me also to be a partner in suicide. Why she did? Because she has low self-esteem. Her own image was so low. When she cannot fight with her husband for her own rights, what she will do for her children? Are you getting my point? If you put a corporate analogy, when I cannot fight for my boss, for my subordinate, when I cannot recommend my subordinate for a promotion, for an increment, for a permission, okay, will that fellow will have confidence in me? He will not have confidence. So 80% of these people, a Gallup survey is telling 86.9% of people on this planet are unhappy, out of which 80% the root cause is mother. Mother university is wrong. The whole university is wrong. We learn, the first thing we learn from is from mother university. The mother university is wrong or impoverished, unproductive. We are blueprint of the same thing. What you are doing, I am unproductive. I make the same blueprint. My son will not change. Same blueprint. Until unless mother challenges it. Or you yourself challenge. 90% will say mother. Until unless the mother challenges. Parental role model. Worldly, yes. What parental role model she had? That, are you getting the point? What parental role model she had? Her parent, what she was doing? If their parents are wrong, these parents are also wrong. So 80% of the mother have full low self-esteem. Therefore, they replicate the same in the children. What you are doing is, you are not revising the format. You are not revising the format. Therefore, one more generation is suffering because of this. Okay? How many of you agree with me? All right, thank you, sir. Why are fathers not taking responsibility? Because the father was modeled by the mother. Anuradha Garu. Anuradha ji, father was modeled by the mother. See, mother is a very big banyan tree. Father is only a branch. Mother is a managing director of the family. Father is only an engineer. Whatever may be, he is only a single officer. Mother is an university. He is only a professor. Okay. Thank you. 90% of you are correct and some people do challenge me. Thank you. Nobody has challenged this group. And that is the reason. What is the age of the youngest dad in this world? Any idea? What is the dad? 13 years. Yeah. Pallavi, right. You are right. Now one Kerala boy, 10 years old boy has broken the record. Sir, what if mother is not so talented? What happened if the teacher is not talented? That will be the teaching syllabus. Okay, mothering is not talent. It is only whatever she does is the outcome. Okay, so 10 years old boy from Kerala has broken the record. What has happened? Yeah, Madhuri, you are right. What has happened? Yeah. This boy, youngest dad in the world. What happened? For him, it was a fun. It was a game. It again goes down to lack of parenting. They did not know what, they were not worried about it. There was one movie called Pavanasam. I don't know how many of you have seen in Tamil. It has come in Telugu. It has come in Hindi also. Ajay Devgan was there. There, the police officer, lady is a police officer. Husband is a busy lawyer. Parenting has very beautifully come out. In fact, I made a review in my YouTube video. Mupatar Vaidinlai, all this made it. There, the father is asking question. Where did the boy go? The boy is a school boy. He is having a car. He is having a laptop. He is having 4 credit cards. Father is telling, where did your son go? She told, I don't know. She is busy inspector wearing the hat and going. She told, I don't know. Where did the boy yesterday? He has spent 60,000 rupees. I am seeing the bill. What the mother does? Oh, nowadays you are going to my son's drawer also. You are doing that jasus. You are doing the policing work. See, mother is not taking as a complaint. Mother is supporting the boy. Finding fault with the husband. Why did you go to my son's table to find out that fellow has done 60,000 rupees? That, I am talking from the movie. Yeah. So, somewhere, who has to take the role, okay? And most of the things, my relationship with the girls, I am very much indebted to Dr. John Gray. I attended his workshop. I have been trained under him. And most of my thinking is based on men are from Mars and women are from Venus. It's another great role model. He's having an island where a lot of experiments for the last 20 years, a lot of videotape, people come and they do volunteer. They record the ECG. And all the biological parameters are monitored, good behavior, bad behavior. And he has identified certain, there are 400 words which create separation, out of which 100 I have identified in my cases in the last 20 years. 4 or 5 words, if you use, we can get diverse within 80%. 80% diverse rate. That is it. These are all my relationship model is, I don't see any better model than these two people. Dr. John Gray and Gottman Institute. And this is my front end for relationship and this is my back end. Back end tool is NLP, Neuro-Linguistic Programming. I learned from Dr. Richard Bandler. And I right and left, I use NLP, Enneagram. Enneagram is another very powerful tool for very precise analysis. Very precise analysis. This is where I was talking on Chennai Forum, Chennai Counselors Forum, Trainers Forum. You can see my photograph here. Similarly, what happens at the neurological level, with what language if you use, what hormone will lead excite, that's what I learned from this man, Richard Bandler. A word is not a mere word. A word is a hormonic trigger. It's creating a hormone. It's creating a hormone. It is decreating a hormone. These two are my back end tools. That is the reason my If you go to my practor.com, you can see hundreds of clients have given their feedback, and they told the same thing. This is my backend tool, and this is my first. I told you now, I'm the first NLP pioneer of India. I am not telling this. A magazine was written this in India. This is my first Tamil book. You can see here. Vetri Kadavu. Kadavu. Karpanai Tarkam Unarchi. NLP VAK. I made it. This is when I was young, around 20 years ago. Still I am young. This is Raj TV. These are my websites. Ha. Yeah. I come back once again to these videos. Everybody told that this lady is correct. Okay. This lady is correct. How many of you agree that lady is correct? Yeah, I want your response. How many of you think that lady is correct? That I will wear any dress I want. Please change your perceptions. Huh? Yes, welcome. I am waiting for your response. Are you there? Anybody? At least type yes. Prasanna, right? Yeah, right. Young. Okay, right. Wrong. Okay. And I am the only guy. I am the only guy who wrote. That was also taught by the mother. You are asking your son to correct. See, I will tell you my own example. When I did, I remember about 8 years, 7 years old, 8 years old. Me and my sister were taking idli in the table. Then, as usual, my father is a traditional guy. He is told, you go and work, daughter will clean that. My mother told, why daughter only should clean? One day she told, you also clean, because you also took idli. So what actually happened is, I started enjoying the dishes. I start making them. My mother told, no, you should also wash, because you have also taken idli. Okay. So because I have also done that, my perception has changed. I go and still cook in my house. Okay. So I always tell my clients when I go to the training. Yeah, hello. Yeah, last yes, point. So I, yeah, some disturbance there. Yeah, last point. I'll just close in another 3 minutes, sir. Communication, sir.
Yeah, fine, sir.
I tell that a person who cannot do for his sister, who cannot wash the linen of his sister, he will not do for his mother. Once he will not do for mother, he will not do for his wife. Once he will not do for the wife, he will not do for his daughter. Once he will not do for the daughter, he will not do for his granddaughter also. Because a bud is to be bent when it is a child. A bud cannot be bent when the tree is like this, it cannot be bent. How many of you agree with me? It's ultimately mothering. After seeing 20 years, I feel yes. Can I improve the mothering?